Here's what to expect on this week's episode of GBTV.
We have a lip sync battle recap.
What are your senior plans for college?
Winter sports are beginning.
And who will win a game of Guess That Carol?
So be sure to stay tuned to hear the full stories. Good afternoon, Eagles, and welcome to this week's episode of GBTV. I'm Kayla.
And I'm Cooper.
I hope everyone had a great Thanksgiving break. How was yours, Cooper?
It was great. I know it was a long break, but do you remember that lip sync battle FBLA put on last Tuesday?
I don't know how anyone could forget, but just in case you missed it, let's head out to Jake and Mark, who have a great recap for us.
I was doing the Sucker for Pain for the lip sync. Now my boys aren't here to interview with me, but I just have to say we did not put any practice into this at all. We just went out there and did our best. First of all, how we got the song was thinking, hey, we really like this song, so heck, why don't we do it? Another thing is, why we enjoyed it so much and how it made it better is when you put a little dance or fun into it, you can make it easy. Anyway, thank you for your time.
Hi, my name is Chris Hicks. I did Tell Me It's Okay by Josh Henderson for the lip sync battles, and my favorite part about doing the song was mainly when I was doing the hand motions with it, because it was really fun. I was nervous though when I did it.
Okay, my name's Caleb Benshoff, and my song was Lunatic Fringe by Red Rider, and I came up with it because this movie I watched, known as Vision Quest, is a really good old wrestling movie that I'd seen, and I just thought it was a really good song and like really intimidating and helpful when I'm wrestling. I just really like the song, so I thought it was cool, and I wanted to try it, and I think I did pretty well. I think the changing the singlets what got him, man.
I chose New Americana by Halsey because I really think that song is, it describes our generation at this time as a whole, and mainly because it's really catchy, and I thought the school would like it.
What is up? I am Cole Trumbull.
Aaron Hayes.
And we are the winners of our lip sync battle. The song we chose was...
Yeah, that's right, we won!
It's true. The song we chose was It Takes Two to Make a Thing Go Right, and we chose that because I was in psychology and Aaron said, hey, Cole, let's do a lip sync battle. It takes two, and I said, we're doing it. And then, well, Aaron, tell them how it went.
It was really good. I mean, we won, we rapped. I thought it took two to make the thing go right, and guess what, we won? And it took two? The other team had three, and that's where it ended up.
It took two to make it more than all right. It took two to be the best. That's all I have to say about that.
We did the song That's My Girl by Fifth Harmony because we figured that doing that song would
give us the victory.
Yeah. And, you know,
we lost to two good guys. I mean, they did really well. Yeah, I mean, we thought we had it, but we didn't. We couldn't pull out.
Before we saw what they did, we honestly thought we were going to win, but we watched what they did and we figured that we still had a chance, but we didn't know.
I'm Ryan.
I'm Jake Salisbury.
And I'm Justin Sackman.
And we're the Rucker Gang.
First off, we think this shouldn't even be a competition because the Rucker Gang was entered in it. So we most likely won the competition is what we're saying.
I think it was easily ours. I just want to thank God for this opportunity. Bless us here. I think love beats all, and the Rucker Gang stands tall, and it shows us who the winner is out here.
We decided to do this song because we just mess heavy with Darius Rucker. And he just puts on out there, and I think the fans realize that. But we're just blessed to be here.
I just want to thank God for Darius Rucker. God bless that man.
I'm as a cold piece, and I'm blessed to be here right now. So, thank.
We appreciate y'all's support. We love y'all.
All right, we are the GV Soccer Boys, and we did Ice Ice Baby by the one and only Vanilla Ice. I thought it went really good out there. It's just the fans were a little bit biased.
But we still went to state.
Yeah, we did.
High School, it's us, the Spice Girls! Woo! Color of the world, spice up your life! This is...
Sporty Spice!
Posh Spice!
Scary Spice!
Ginger Spice!
And I'm Baby Spice! Thanks for letting us come here to America and do our songs. Bye, thanks!
You know, we knew we were the best all along with just how stacked and talent we are. We're unbeatable, honestly.
Yeah, I'm Harry, and I think that was a very hard-fought win. I am winded.
Yeah, really all in a day's work. The teachers brought it, but we brought it even bigger. So that was a hard-fought battle. I think the teacher did a great job, but got that W.
I'm pretty heavy. I pretty winded after that, but you gotta do whatever it takes to get the championship.
Backstreet's back, baby.
Wow, I wish I could have participated. Great job to everyone involved.
Well, I know I'm looking forward to next year's lip sync battle.
You know, Kayla, coming back from this Thanksgiving break has reminded me how fast the school year is going by. I mean, it's already close to the end of the first semester.
I know, the year's flying by. I bet a lot of seniors are deciding what colleges they would like to go to next year.
Me too. I wonder where they are all planning to go.
Good thing Cindy and Shelby are here to tell us where some of the seniors plan to go after they graduate.
What's up, GV? I'm Sydney.
And I'm Shelby.
And as we are nearing the end of the first semester of this school year, lots of seniors have made their decision on where they want to spend the next 4 years of their life after high school.
Let's go interview some students and learn more about it. Hi, I'm here with Kendall Bailey. And Kendall, where did you sign to play softball?
University of Missouri.
And why did you choose that school?
To stay close to home.
And why are you excited for Mizzou?
The college experience and to play softball at the next level.
Thank you.
Kyle, where are you committed to going to college next year?
I have committed to Johnson County Community College.
And what made you want to make that decision?
Well, one, it's close to home. So if anything were to happen, obviously my parents are still there. And another reason is the coaching staff actually... I know a lot of them, and it gives me the experience of college ball before I officially go away for a couple more years. So,
and what are you nervous for?
Definitely the classes. You know, you have to maintain a certain GPA to continue to play ball. So that's a big factor for it.
Okay, thank you so much, Kyle.
Shelby, where are you going to college?
University of Arkansas.
And what made you want to make that decision?
I really like the campus and they have good programs for what I want to do.
And what are you nervous for about going to Arkansas?
Not knowing anybody.
Okay, thank you.
Lake, where are you committed to going to college?
Northwest Missouri State.
And what made you want to make that decision?
My cousin graduated from there about 2 years ago through the elementary education department. She said that she really liked the school. And then I've had a few friends that were looking at there too, so I most definitely, that is what impacted me to go to Northwest.
And what are you nervous about?
I'm nervous about living on my own for the first time, but I know that I'm definitely excited to live on my own and live with a roommate and be a whole new experience for everything in my life.
Okay, thank you so much.
Ariana, where are you going to college?
I'm going to the University of Arkansas.
And what made you want to make that decision?
I visited the campus and it was really pretty and not a lot of people are going there.
Awesome. And are you nervous for anything for going to Arkansas?
I'm just nervous for rooming with somebody like I've never met before.
Okay, thank you.
We are so proud of you guys and we hope you all the best next year.
Congratulations, guys, and back to you in the studio.
Thanks, Sydney and Shelby, and congratulations to all of the college commits.
We can't wait to see what you all achieve next year.
Before we continue, let's take a quick break and hear from our sponsors.
Introducing our new grilled chicken. Hungry for more? Go to grilledlove.com.
All this talk, college commitments make me so excited for winter sports this year.
I know, I can't wait to go to all of the games.
Armand and Amanda have an insight on what to expect for this year's winter sports.
Hey, I'm Armand.
And I'm Amanda.
And let's go talk to some of the boys and girls basketball players.
And wrestlers about their upcoming season.
Let's check it out. With varsity basketball player Kendall Bailey, what skills are you guys going to focus on this season?
We really need Maddie Canoost, Brittany McKay, and Kendra Seibert to step up this year.
All right, okay. And how does this season compare to last one?
Hopefully we can make it farther. We just need one more game to make this state.
All right, thank you. So I'm here with Marcel. How do you think you're going to do this season?
We'll be pretty good. We're a pretty more athletic team this year, so we should get a lot accomplished as long as we keep our mind straight and do what coach wants us to do. We'll be pretty good.
All right. And do you have any upcoming games?
Tuesday we play at Fort Osage. JV plays at 5:30 and then varsity's right after that.
All right. And who do you think is going to be the most challenging team this year?
Most of the teams give us some pretty good competition, but we normally always have competition with Harrisonville, so they'll be a pretty good game.
All right. Thank you. Make sure you guys go out and support your GV winter sports teams.
Back to you guys in the studio.
Speaking of winter, I'm so excited for my favorite holiday that's coming up this month.
Wait, what's your favorite holiday?
Let's head out to Ben, Lexi, and Aaron, and they will explain it all.
Hey guys, it's Lexi here. And with Thanksgiving wrapping up, that now means it's acceptable to listen to Christmas music. Stay tuned for our first ever Guess That Carol.
Rocking around the Christmas tree.
You gave it away.
last Christmas.
Oh, the weather outside.
Let it snow.
But the fire is so... It's beginning to look a lot.
It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas. Polar Express.
Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer.
It's the most wonderful.
It's the most wonderful time of the year.
I want a hippopotamus for Christmas.
I want a hippopotamus.
Here comes Santa Claus. Santa Claus, right down Santa Claus.
Jingle bells.
It looks like our Green Valley students are officially ready for the holiday and all the music that comes along with it. Back to you in the studio.
Oh, it's Christmas. That makes sense.
Yeah, and some of the guy students really got that whole carol thing down.
They sure do. Thanks, Lexi, Ben, and Aaron, and all of you students.
Well, that's all we have for you this week, GV.
Don't forget to follow us on Instagram, Twitter, and Snapchat.
@GVHS Eagle Media.
Have a great weekend.
And see you all next week.